Welcome into Toyota Park, the Chicago Red Stars versus the Seattle Reign, presented by Nongshim, the first of three remaining home matches for the Chicago Red Stars. I'm Lisa Byington, alongside Jackie Manny, formerly Jackie Santa Catarina. And as always, you can tune into our Spanish webcast and listen in to Tico Fernandez. Well, a big match, a big playoff implication match between these two teams. And so let's go back and look at the last time that these two took on an opponent. It was Chicago against Sky Blue, and Stephanie McCaffrey got things going with a unique angle on this cross.
She did. She's on the right flank, and it looks like she just means to cross it in, and it catches the outside of her foot, so you find this in-swinger that comes into the back post on Sky Blue.
It was her second start and her second goal, so very productive once she's been put in the starting lineup, and then just a weird and dramatic sequence of events. Multiple saves on the goal line for the Red Stars, and then this play eventually ends in an offside call.
It does, but a crazy sequence. Nair with a great stop, and then you saw Gilliland and just come with a bicycle off of the goal line to save it.
And then an absolute beautiful play. Vanessa DiBernardo finding Kristen Press. Press doing a good job and just staying on side, and DiBernardo doing a good job in reading the play.
She does. She baits the back line a little bit, waits for her opening, and then just patiently finds Kristen Press on a little diagonal run.
Kristen Press, fifth goal of the year. It was her first time back from the Olympics. And then off the cross, Erin Gilliland with the flick on and Sofia Huerta with the finish.
Sofia Huerta was wide open on the back post. Erin Gilliland with a great flick. Sofia gets able to take a touch and then just calmly slots it in with her left.
Well, the Red Stars pick up 3 points with a 3-1 victory over Sky Blue FC. So let's check in with Seattle. The last time they played, it was a rivalry game against Portland. Nahu Kawasumi finds a beautiful ball, or places a beautiful ball to Manon Mellis for the finish.
She does. She finds this outswinger into her run, and she's able to one-time it. And then you see here again, Mellis strikes. She pressures the Portland back line, able to take it easily off of Sonnet, and then finishes near post.
Mellis with 5 goals on the year, and she had a brace against her rival in Portland. Take one more look at it. And so Seattle went up 2-0 in this match. Well, Portland had a response. This is Allie Long in stoppage time.
Big diagonal ball off of a free kick. Allie Long makes a run that she frees up on and just calmly slips it in with the outside of her foot. But then right away, Seattle strikes back. You see Jess Fishlock on the right side, plays it into a Megan Rapinoe's run. And good for Megan Rapinoe. She's finished it, buries it in with her left foot.
It was her season debut. She's still battling back from that ACL. But you see that Seattle victorious 3-1 also over Portland. So that's the setup. This is the first of 2 games in 4 days at Toyota Park for the Red Stars. We got the kickoff coming next.
Wouldn't it be great to feel this good every day? Doing the things you love with the people you love. At Illinois Bone and Joint Institute, we help people of all ages move better so they can live better. If an orthopedic injury or illness slows you down, we're here with everything you need. Enjoy the life you deserve. See what we can do for you at IBJI.com. IBJI, move better, live better.
Back here at Toyota Park, we have a tight race as we head down the stretch of the regular season of the NWSL. Top four, again, make the playoffs in the NWSL. 4 matches left, including tonight, for these two teams. Chicago and Seattle, we are moments away here from kickoff. Again, Jackie Manny and Lisa Byington with you. You see the standings here in the Washington Spirit trying to lock out that number one seed. But you look at Chicago Red Stars sitting at 28. This is an important playoff competition here tonight between Chicago and Seattle, just 5 points off of that fourth place spot. Western New York battling for it. So down the stretch we come for both of those clubs. As for the starting 11 between these two teams, the Chicago Red Stars, Stephanie McCaffrey has responded to the starting role really in the last 2 games, Jackie.
She has. She's found her stride here in Chicago. She's come up with some big goals, and I think she'll just keep getting better and better the more comfortable she gets here.
As for Seattle, Manon Mellis, we showed her in the open, a reigning NWSL Player of the Week, and for good reason.
You're right. She had 2 goals last week. She's fast. She's dangerous around the goal. And with Seattle's back against the wall in their playoff hunt, I think they'll rely on her to get them on the board tonight.
A goal in the 27th minute against Portland and a goal in the 50th minute. Again, this match so important in terms of playoff implications. The top four in the NWSL make it. And Seattle is nipping at Chicago's heels.
Yeah, it's a huge game. We talked to Coach Laura Harvey before, and she just talked about how every game your back's against the wall. You don't really have an option not to do well, not to win.
Underway here at Toyota Park, a match between the Seattle Reign and the Chicago Red Stars from Bridgeview, Illinois. Seattle in the bright fluorescent yellow uniforms, and Chicago with a little bit of a different look with the black and the blue. Laura Harvey, after that Portland win, a 3-1 win for Seattle, had said that, you know, our team has developed a championship mentality.
They have, and I mean, just off of their past seasons as well, not just this season, they've struggled a little bit to find their stride with things, but she said that their backs against the wall mentality has led them to find their consistency, which is what they struggled finding in the beginning of the season.
That's a different position than what they found themselves in the last couple of years. Seattle Reign, 2014 and 2015, the NWSL Shield winners. Winners of the regular season, that included a 2014 year where they had a 16-game unbeaten streak. That was the longest in the NWSL before actually that streak ended, courtesy of the Red Stars back on July 13th of 2014.
It did. Red Stars have a pretty good track record against Seattle. They haven't won when they've been here in Chicago, so that's another thing that they'll be looking to do. But yeah, their backs are against the wall, and Coach said that they've relished in that role so far.
Jessica Fishlock a little bit slow to get up, but she pops up. A lot of these players, the series goes way back, as you had mentioned, a pretty even series. A lot of these players know each other well. Fishlock was one, and back in the locker room, she wanted to get permission from Rory Dames to just go say hello to friends, and he's like, you can just walk in. And she said, I'm the enemy tonight. I can't just walk in.
She wanted to say hi to friends, and I think she wanted a cup of coffee, too.
So we really have Kristen Press for Chicago starting to get in that number 10 spot for the Red Stars. We also want to remind you that each and every Red Stars home match, we have a live online auction. And to bid, we're going to have this up until the 70th minute as the first attempt there for Seattle goes way wide. But to bid, you just have to text 52182 and you can get yourself into bidding for a Karina LeBlanc signed jersey, an Aaron Gilliland warm-up top, and also an on-field experience for four at a future Red Stars match. So all of those are available, and all you have to do is text the code word Red Stars to 52182 all the way up into the 70th minute of play tonight. There's Press with a touch. I mentioned that she's getting the start at the 10th spot. We may or may not see Taylor Como. She is slotted as a sub here tonight for Chicago.
If you are a loved one, is hurt or feeling pain,
and she makes a huge difference in terms of if she is healthy, and right now she's dealing with a right hamstring injury, but if she's healthy, that adjusts the Chicago lineup to a very favorable lineup that they'd like to have probably coming down the stretch here and into the playoffs.
I think they've just found a little bit of a groove with Como in that outside mid spot so that Vanessa can get in that number 10 spot and kind of find that playmaking ability that she's so dangerous with.
Well, including tonight, both of these clubs, as I had mentioned, have four matches left in the Speedy. Mathias on that right side. She'll be very active on that right side as Seattle attacks on that right side. We will see Mathias move up and down.
We will. You'll see Neho kind of pinch in, and Mathias will be able to just run that right flank a ton. And then Seattle's midfield is so good just at keeping the ball, spraying it out wide. They're a possession-based team, and they're good at kind of getting teams tighter and then spreading them out and attacking those wide spaces.
Our conversation with Laura Harvey, she wouldn't tell us really if she expected Megan Rapinoe, who is slotted to be a sub here tonight, how often and how many minutes she could put her in. Said that Rapinoe would be more of a situation-based sub probably here tonight. Yanez with the touch, and Seattle just like that, the goal. Once again, Manon Mellis, her hot streak continues, and Seattle goes up 1-0.
You see here, a great ball in. Melis makes that tiny diagonal run. She's in between the outside backs and the center back. Gets herself freed up and one times it with her right foot. She gets right inside Sam Johnson. Little diagonal ball through Cole Aprico and Sam Johnson. She catches Manon right on the right spot and just an easy finish. Pass Nair.
It is tough to find maybe a hotter goal scorer right now than Manon Melis for Seattle. Mentioned the brace that she got against Portland. Now she gets a goal here, I believe, in the fifth minute. Out of the gate, Seattle starting things off where they want to be.
She's fast and she's just hungry around the goal all the time. She likes being in those scoring opportunities, so she's constantly looking for those chances in goal.
Goal did come in the fifth minute of play. Seattle went up 2-0 against Portland in the last match.
He did. It was a little bit of a weird finish against Portland. Two goals in added time. Just kind of one of those weird soccer games. But like Laura Harvey said, like we mentioned, Seattle's definitely finding their stride a little bit with this new backs against the wall mentality that they have.
Now the next three of four games, very to the rain. They're at Washington September 7th and they're home again to Washington September 11th. They wrap up the regular season September 25th against Houston.
Yeah, they've got some big games to close out their season. Three of the four in those playoff contention spots.
Two of the three against the first place team, Washington Spirit. So their road is not going to be very easy here down the stretch. Chicago has an equally challenging road facing against FC KC a couple of times, two of the last three matches to end the regular season. An FC KC team that will most likely be very hungry. They sit tonight, coming into tonight, they sit with 16 points, but awfully hungry to put themselves move up the playoff standings if they could, or move up the NWSL standings if they could, or perhaps play spoiler here. Fishlock in the middle of the field. A whistle and a free kick coming up here for the Seattle Reign. You saw Laura Harvey, the coach of the year in 2015 and 2014. Again, her team now playing the role of the chaser instead of the chasee in the regular season. And this is a dangerous spot for Chicago. And Seattle Reign setting up. You see Rory Dames, he said, lately, you know, with our success against Seattle, we've done a good job not worrying about what Seattle will do. And that's one of the reasons why we've had some success against them in this series. So Kim Little is lining up for this free kick. And it won't be Little who takes it, and they find it in the right side corner. Seattle going up 2-0. Lauren Barnes with the lefty strike.
You see her here. She comes at it with her left foot. She bends it just over the top and the inside of the Chicago wall and slots it into that near post. You see it again. Doesn't even take much of a run-up. Just gets out her foot on the outside of the ball, gets that outswinging spin, and gets it right over the goal into the near post.
An unassisted goal in the ninth minute of play. Lauren Barnes' first goal of 2016. It was a beauty. So Chicago a little bit snake bitten here to start this match.
They definitely are. We'll see how they react. Chicago has always been good with that blue collar mentality that they kind of show through in these grittier situations. So it is early. They're down 2-0, but there's plenty of game for Chicago to get themselves back into it.
Well, Seattle is doing something to Alyssa Nair that really hasn't been done all season long. Nair, the first time going into this matchup between Seattle and Chicago way back in May. Remember, Nair had a four-game scoreless streak going on, and it took a Kim Little PK towards the end of the match to actually be the first one to score, and it prevented a fifth straight game of a clean sheet for Alyssa Nair. That would have set an NWSL record.
It is. It's an unlikely start for Chicago in general, let alone just Alyssa Nair. But again, I think we talked a little bit about with Coach Dames, just how to get their players back into the lineup that are coming back from their national teams. I think it takes a little bit of gelling, a little bit more getting used to just with the changes in your lineup, especially when you have three like Chicago does. It's just kind of takes some time to get everything gelling and everything on the same page again, especially against a really good Seattle team who is so hungry to find their spot in the playoffs.
Rory Dames had said that all three, Kristen Press and Julie Johnston and Alyssa Nair, all contacted him. Obviously, the U.S. team finished their Olympic trip a little bit earlier than what they wanted, but they all contacted him and tried to touch base on when it would be okay to return. They've all been together for about 2 weeks now, trying to train, develop that chemistry, get that chemistry back, and obviously it's something that all of these teams in the NWSL have had to deal with, some more than others, in terms of roster spots. Direct pass up top, a nice touch. And Seattle controls possession. Again, here's Yanez. Yanez has the assist on the first goal and came in the fifth minute to Manon Mellis. Cutback move up top to Kim Little.
That's where you see Mathias getting herself up that right flank. And as you just saw, Seattle does such a good job at drawing the midfielders of Chicago in and then just finding those wide players to get everybody involved in the attack.
Laura Harvey, really, formation-wise, you could play a 3-5-2. But Mathias's role would be what within that formation and that system?
It's kind of like a 4-4-2. They just start more defensively. So defensively, you'll see Mathias cheat back a little bit and kind of be in that outside back, that outside right back position. And then as soon as Seattle gets the ball, she is out. Neho drives herself up, so she's almost into their forward line. And you kind of see this 3-5-2 take shape whenever they're on offense.
Kendall Fletcher, Lauren Barnes getting the start back there as well. As Fishlock places it back.
It's a hard shape to deal with, especially if you're a Chicago team who likes their outside backs to drive up into play. And now they have to sit a little bit more defensively to deal with those five in the middle and those two up top. You'll see Mathias way out wide again. She's running up, and it just draws Steph McCaffrey to have to come in and play way more defense than Chicago would like her to.
Well, Seattle has been absolutely lights out in terms of offensive chances here to start this match. Already a couple of goals. And all the shot attempts. I don't remember Chicago getting a shot here early.
They haven't really crossed their half, to be honest. They've had some longer balls where they're getting up out of their back, but they haven't been able to find any sort of rhythm and connect any passes to really generate some offensive chances.
Starting up top again, as we had mentioned, Steph McCaffrey and Cara Walls. Although Kristen Press has now pushed up. The cross into the box. Yanez couldn't quite get to it. Here's Alyssa Nair. I mentioned she started the NWSL season 485 minutes of scoreless soccer, which ended the last time that Seattle and Chicago met. It was a 2-1 win by Chicago back on May 22nd at Memorial Stadium. The lone goal, Kim Little, it was a PK. And it ended, as I mentioned, the shutout streak by Alyssa Nair. Both goals by Chicago from Jen Hoy, who's not available tonight for Chicago, dealing with a plantar fasciitis injury. Combination look out to Rumi Utsugi. Look out, another chance to save that time by Nair.
Mellis just causing all sorts of problems for Chicago's back line. She does such a good job at sitting in between the back line and finding little opportunities to just spray herself into the final third. They're just struggling right now to really kind of get off of their heels, get themselves into their attacking half, and find any sort of rhythm. Seattle's doing such a good job at getting numbers forward and driving Chicago back.
Out to the right flank, Nahu Kawasumi. It's Kawasumi and Usugi, who are Japanese national pickups for Seattle, officially signed in June. Laura Harvey and Seattle have been actively pursuing them. With Rumi, they identified her in the World Cup last year, but she had a contract with France at the time, and they finally sealed the deal last September of 2015. And for Nahu, they've asked her, she joked, Laura Harvey joked, we asked her about like 9 times, and then it was the 10th time when she finally said yes.
Auto call.
Persistence paying off with that one. Kawasumi, an Olympic silver medalist for Japan back in 2012. Again, she had signed with the Reign in June 16th of 2016. Here again is Mellis. Kim Little trying to run on. And Sam Johnson is the one who clears. The Chicago back line looking more like a familiar back line with Julie Johnston getting another start back there, back after the Olympic break.
She's a big piece to the Chicago defense. She organizes, she's the communicator, kind of that leader of the back line, and especially with her and Nair back together with that relationship that they've formed, you'd think that they'll be harder to score on. I think they just, like we said, they need to find their chemistry again.
Listen there, you just never know what her future also is going to be with Team USA. Of course, Hope Solo, it's been a big story. She took an indefinite leave from the Reign following the announcement of her suspension from U.S. soccer. Alyssa Nair, the backup in the 2016 Rio Olympic Games. You know, Laura Harvey talking to us before the game. As Seattle looking to attack and looking to thread the needle, and it's Nair coming out. That was her only choice of playing it with her feet.
It's a big time step by Alyssa Nair. She was high enough off her line, read the game well enough to be higher up and be able to sweep that up as the ball came deep through.
Laura Harvey telling us with the Hope Solo situation, they understood it was difficult for her to make the decision that she did, but they wanted to support her. In fact, they are encouraging her to come around the team after they're done with this road trip and even be more of like a staff role. Help out the team in that way here down the stretch.
And Laura Harvey mentioned that her experience would be invaluable to any organization. And I think that's a great approach for somebody who's kind of struggling with their given situation at the time. And it seems like Seattle is great in terms of the support that they're giving her.
In the meantime, it's Haley Kottmeyer. You saw her get a touch there. Haley Kottmeyer getting another start. Played 5 years at the University of Michigan. She is a Michigan native, the career leader. She graduated as the career leader at U of M in saves, goals against average, shutouts, minutes played. Illinois Bone and Joint Institute is the proud sponsor of 2016 for the Chicago Red Stars. Illinois Bone and Joint Institute, you can find them, more information at ibji.com.
Mentioned Kottmeyer, she's been with the organization for 4 years now, and she's been that consistent goalkeeper that stepped in for Hope every time that she's been with the national team. So I think it's a pretty easy transition. Laura Harvey mentioned, you know, it's never easy to replace somebody like Hope Solo, but it has been a decently easy transition for them just because she's had so much experience in this role.
Press knocks it to DiBernardo. Really, Chicago's first chance of the night. Again, want to remind you, each and every Red Stars home game, we will have a live online auction. Bidding is open until the 70th minute of the match. Text the code word Red Stars to 52182. You can get in on a Karina LeBlanc signed jersey and Aaron Gilliland warm-up top. and an on-field experience for four at a future Red Stars match. All kinds of goodies here tonight that you can bid on. Text the code word Red Stars to 52182. If you're just joining us, you missed a couple of goals already by Seattle. One in the fifth minute, one in the ninth minute, I believe. Beviana has found Manon Mellis for the first goal, and then Lauren Barnes on a free kick opportunity.
Chicago finally starting to find a little bit of rhythm offensively. Still kind of waiting for that spark. They just look a little bit dead in every position on the field right now.
Here's Gilliland. We talked about them maybe getting shell-shot. Down 2-0 in the first 10 minutes of play. This Seattle team is playing awfully hungry in the last few matches. They have to accumulate points. They have to get points with teams like Chicago above them. Whoa, Carr Walls! Kuttmeyer is there! And McCaffrey couldn't finish.
Finally, a decent chance for Chicago, and hopefully they can use that as a little bit of a game changer, a little bit of a momentum swing to get some energy, get some more going on the attack. It's also one thing that Coach Dames mentioned in the beginning of the game is that Seattle's going to score goals. They have so many threats offensively. They're so dangerous in their movements. They're going to score goals, but being able to kind of reciprocate and find goals on the opposite end is going to be big for Chicago.
Stephanie McCaffrey nearly had her third goal in her third straight start with Chicago. This is her fourth game that she's played since the trade was made in July. And McCaffrey's numbers are awfully impressive in those four games with Chicago, as opposed to with Boston. She didn't have a goal, didn't have an assist in 12 games, played 921 minutes so far this year, as opposed to three games coming into tonight and a couple of goals already.
I think she's just a little bit more comfortable here. Sometimes your style of play doesn't match with your team's style of play, unfortunately. And I think she's found her rhythm, like we talked about. She's got a little bit more freedom in the lineup, in her position that she's in. And I think she's more comfortable with that.
Confidence is improving. Her fitness is returning. Perfect timing for Chicago in terms of trying to make a playoff run.
Chicago's finding their rhythm, just because if you look now, you see the outside backs wrapped up a little bit more, which makes Chicago so dangerous when you can get Casey Short all the way high up onto that line. It just gives Chicago so many more opportunities to attack the back and get numbers in the box.
Casey Short sends it in to the head of Kristen Press, and Erin Gilliland a little late to finish that one. Kristen Press is listed at 5'6". She needed to be about 5'8" to reach that one. Reminder to text Red Stars to 52182. You can get involved with our online auction that will take place all the way up into the 70th minute of play. A LeBlanc signed jersey, a Gilliland warm up top, and an on field experience at a future Red Stars match. But suddenly, in the last few series here, Chicago has gotten some decent looks.
They are, and like we mentioned that Coach Dames talked about, is just playing how they normally play, not worrying about Seattle, but finding their own rhythm, what makes them good, and they're finally starting to do that by pushing their outside backs up and just getting a little bit more possession-based in their midfield, getting balls out wide instead of playing so much defense, especially with Steph McCaffrey coming back and having to play defense as well.
Press will play it back to Sam Johnson. And Mellis is going to challenge every drop back pass to Alyssa Nair tonight, it looks like.
Everyone on Seattle, they're such a high pressure team that really no pass back is safe.
Here's Johnston to Huerta, and pressure from Fishlot. Trying to go up and over to Kristen Press. And Gilliland on the right side. Casey Short looking to go to work against Kawasumi. And the first corner kick opportunity for Chicago.
This Red Stars corner kick brought to you by the Illinois Women's Soccer League.
First Red Stars corner kick of the night brought to you by the Illinois Women's Soccer League. For every Red Stars corner kick this year, IWSL will donate a game ticket to a local nonprofit organization. There's DiBernardo lining up to take it. Lofton ball to the back post. Beautifully done. My goodness, that was a gorgeous finish. Sofia Huerta. Goal number 5 on the year.
She scored in similar fashion last week against Sky Blue. She sits at that back post and is so dangerous at getting up and over. You see a great lofted ball into the back post. She gets up and over and sends it straight into that upper corner. Again, she gets up and over, and it's just a driven ball right past the keeper.
Just a sliver of space, and she found it. Top corner. Cuts the lead 2-1.
And I think we'll see more so from here on out with this 2-1 scoreline, the game that we were expecting. Tons of offense, tons of excitement around the game, and just kind of a full-out battle between these two teams.
Assisted by number 10, Vanessa DiBernardo.
It's the sixth assist for Vanessa DiBernardo. The goal coming in the 27th minute of play. Here's McCaffrey. Maybe that'll light a fire under this Chicago team.
You're already seeing a little bit faster movements, even from the back lineup of Chicago. Just a little bit more motivation, a little bit more of a spark throughout the whole team right now.
Huerta now ties Kristen Press for the team lead with 5 goals apiece. As you watch the Red Stars on the field, know that you can get geared up just like your favorite players, jerseys, sweatshirts, just about anything else your Red Stars wear or use. You can log on to redstarsgear.com today.
To find a location near you, Athletico is the official provider of physical therapy and athletic training for the Chicago Red Stars. Athletico physical therapy, better for everybody.
Kottmeyer will reset for Seattle.
Unlucky touch by Fishlock to give Chicago another chance closer to their goal.
Well, in this league now, there's an interesting race for the scoring champion. Ohio out of Houston leads the way with 9 goals, followed by Lynn Williams, who's having a great offensive year for Western New York with 8. You go down the list and you get to the 5th spot, and there is a bunch of players who are tied with 5 goals, Kristen Press being one, and now Sofia Huerta also being another. Manon Mellis coming into tonight was in that group. She's got 6 goals now on the year. And 3 of her 6, half of her goals have come in the last 2 games.
You can see her just keep getting more and more confidence as those goals come in too. Like I said, she's just kind of a workhorse. She creates her own scoring opportunities a lot of the time.
Already three goals here. With about 15 minutes left here in this first half, here's Fishlock trying to make that turn. And Seattle's going to have a corner kick coming.
It's a great defensive play by Vanessa DeBernard to track her back and not allow one of those crosses on goal.
Kawasumi and Lauren Barnes are the ones headed over. Barnes has that lethal left foot. We saw it in the second goal. She blasted a shot into the right corner and right past Alyssa Nair. Here's the lefty strike. Julie Johnston trying to get rid of it. Kristen Press with the clear. Throw in coming up here for Seattle.
And a much better job by Chicago defensively.
Red Stars broadcast brought to you in part by Blooming Color, the official printer of the Chicago Red Stars. They made area businesses stand out for the past 25 years. BloomingColor.com is where you can find them online.
Carl Walls is another one that's been great so far for Chicago this half. She's done a great job at holding up that ball and allowing the Red Stars to get forward and join the attack.
And Carl Walls is one who's gotten a little bit more playing time with the likes of like a Taylor Como, who has been injured for Chicago.
She has, and she's matured as a player as she's gotten more and more time. She's gotten more comfortable. She's got a taller, stronger build. And alongside a Steph McCaffrey-like player, she's great up top as a target role. You've seen her tonight get a ton of balls into her feet, been able to hold them up and find a Kristen Press or a Vanessa DiBernardo to really generate their offense.
And remember, fans, in the 34th minute, sing along with Local 134 Supporters Group. When you hear, when you wish upon
a... Utsuki. Beautiful ball again trying to go to Mellis.
She loves those diagonal runs in with those outswinging balls where they're coming away from the keeper, but they're still behind the back line. They're so hard to deal with defensively.
They have found her. They've bended it perfectly up top. There was a beautiful pass by Kawasumi in the Portland match that was basically on the right side, but it also found Mellis for her first goal in that match.
It did. It was the same type of ball. And Seattle's midfield is so good at those little 1-2s, like we said, that draw the defense in. They get the ball out wide, and then they just find those diagonal balls onto the running Mellis.
Jackie Manny, Lisa Byington with you. Thank you for tuning in. Seattle, Chicago. Trying to battle for a playoff spot. A run from DiBernardo, couldn't quite get to it. Press trying to keep it in this attacking third, but to the feet of Kim Little. Little, of course, the NWSL MVP, Golden Boot Award winner in 2014.
She's such a fun player to watch. She can kind of seem like she's quiet in games, but she does so much work on the field, offensively and defensively.
Well, she's pushed it up, tried to find the head of Giannis. Well, Seattle has attacked in several different ways. They've gone to Mellis several different times. That way they were trying to find the head of Giannis.
That's what makes them so dangerous, is they get so many different players, so many numbers forward. It's so hard to track defensively. When they get those players forward, they do such a good job with Fishlock and Winters kind of sitting in that block defensively, which allows their outside backs to get so far forward and join the attack.
going at speed. Probably one of the reasons why Rory Dames was joking with us before this match when I said, what are your concerns with Seattle? And he just kind of laughed and he said, the list is shorter if I told you the things I'm not concerned about with Seattle. He was acknowledging right out of the gates how talented this Rain team is.
They do. They just see the game so well. They interchange so well, which makes it so hard to track. And it provides all those scoring opportunities in so many different ways. They don't just play direct. They don't just find those diagonal balls in. They get everybody involved into their attacking possession style games.
Well, the series has really been evenly matched. Chicago with a 4-3-3 overall record. And the Rain haven't beaten Chicago, though, going back to the 2014 year. Here's Fishlock. A distance try. Chicago awfully tough at home here at Toyota Park this year. A 4-0-3 record. They are the only NWSL team left that is still unbeaten on their home turf. I guess I should say home grass when we're talking about Toyota Park.
The lovely Toyota Park grass. It's a huge stat to be able to have, being at home, especially when you're late into the season. Just having that confidence when you're at home is big in the playoff runs.
On the flip side, Seattle has actually struggled on the road. They come into tonight with a 1-3-3 road record. The Red Stars broadcast brought to you in part by Athletico, the official physical therapy and athletic trainers of this team. Athletico is better for everybody. You can find them online at athletico.com. Down the left side, Utsugi got it into the box, and there's Aaron Gilliland who goes off Utsugi.
Next Yoga is the official yoga partner of the 26th.
We haven't seen an attack really as much on the left side as Seattle seems to like to go up that right flank.
They do, and that's where they have Neho come inside and Matthias kind of drive up. But then usually Bevianas just kind of poaches in that left spot. She's open for those diagonal balls that come out wide. So she might be a little bit quiet right now, but look for her to get more involved in the attack as the game progresses.
Flag was up from the sideline. So a restart here for Seattle. Pressure now coming. A little bit of applied pressure from Cara Walls. Out to Utsugi. Less than 10 minutes to play here before the half. At halftime, a real treat. Julianne Sitch, the former Chicago Red Star, will be honored after her announcing her retirement after about 14 seasons of play. And you know Julianne very well.
I do, yes. One of my all-time favorite teammates, to be exact. Just has the biggest heart on her. She comes to practice every day and just works harder than anybody else does. And it's a big deal for her to be honored tonight. She put so much heart, so much time into Chicago and building up their team, their brand, as this league kind of came back into play. And it was so fun playing alongside her for as long as I did.
She had three separate stints with the Red Stars, one in the WPS, one in the WPSL, and one in the NWSL. One of those unique players who's played in all three of those professional leagues, played at DePaul, just down the street here from Toyota Park in 2002 to 2005. Julie Johnston with the clear. Oh, and by the way, if you're interested, though, Saturday, September 24th, it'll be Jackie Manny's, formerly Jackie Santa Catarina Day.
It will. I'm excited for that day.
7 p.m. kick against the Washington Spirit. It'll also be Fan Appreciation Night. If you're interested in the next few matches, there's another one for Chicago coming up on Wednesday of this week, September 7th. Tickets for all games available at chicagoredstars.com, or you can call 773-697-8699. Of course, all the national team players, all the call-up players now back with their respective teams. Fun to watch some of the players who you actually got to watch in the Olympics. They're back. to end the season here in the NWSL. Just about 5 minutes to play in this first half. A 2-1 score. Both of these coaches, Laura Harvey and Rory Dames, thought there might be a lot of scoring, and we've definitely seen it with three goals here in the first half. Walls plays it out to Casey Short.
If you or a loved one is hurt or feeling pain, where would you go for care? Illinois Bone and Joint Institute is the choice for many people and families who want the best in orthopedic care.
And both these teams are playing at their best. They kind of play a similar style, which I think is why you keep seeing one team dominate for 5 or so minutes and then Chicago dominate for 5 or so minutes, just because they get their outside backs wrapped forward. You see that block with Chicago of Johnston, Johnson, and Cole Aprico, and similar with Seattle, the Winters, Barnes, and Fletcher.
Fish trying to place it. Fish lock two. Oh, the save from there. Can you believe it? She had to do it twice to keep that one out of the net.
Is huge by Nair, especially so late in the second, in the first half, when you're down by a goal already. It's a huge difference going into your halftime. 2-1 down instead of 3-1. You'll see it here again. Yanez gets a shot. Nair's going one way. She's able to change her body position, get a little flick, and provide enough time to get under the ball and knock it out of harm's way.
It was a beautifully played ball from Fishlock to find Yanez in the first place. And Alyssa Nair, reaction time, absolutely lights out here to end this first half. Keep the score at 2-1.
Is a huge save for Chicago as a team.
You may not realize it, the Chicago Red Stars Academy offers girls ages 8 through 17 elite training through residential day camps, personal training, and it happens through Chicagoland, Indiana, and Wisconsin. If you're interested, you can head to redstarsacademy.com. Well, if this first half is any indication of what the second half is going to be, we are in for a treat. A couple of defensive stances, three goals scored already in this first half. You can tell both of these teams are hungry for playoff positioning. Yanez.
Check out Mama Ball, the ultimate soccer training ball. Its unique grip design can help improve your touch, control, and technique. Check out the Mama Ball crew on the field at halftime and visit MamaBall.com for further information. Mama Ball, proud partner of the Chicago Red Stars.
Final few minutes before the half.
Get pumped for the second half with some Highball Energy. Delicious, premium, natural, healthy, organic energy. Highball is the healthiest and most effective energy drinks on the planet.
Chicago's pretty content right now. It's sitting around half, not really high pressuring Seattle, just kind of letting them play around the back.
Here comes some pressure from McCaffrey. They'll play it back to Kottmeyer.
Another thing Chicago's kind of struggled with is just keeping the ball on one side. Defensively, Chicago relies on their ability to cut the field in half, keep them to one side, get everything really tight. And they've struggled with them just because Seattle moves so well in different positionings.
Well, Here's Kottmeyer. Kottmeyer playing in her fourth game. Her eighth game in 2016. You had mentioned that she's in her fourth year with Seattle. There's the whistle, and we're at the half. Take a deep breath. There's been a lot of action in the first 45.
It was a busy half. It started off kind of lackluster for Chicago. They were able to get themselves back in the game and cut the lead in half. And then a huge save by Alyssa Nair to keep this game at 2-1 going into halftime.
First it was Mellis in the 5th minute. Barnes in the 9th minute for Seattle to go ahead 2-0. And then DiBernardo with the assist. And it was Sofia Huerta with the goal in the 27th minute. So DiBernardo with the assist, Huerta with the goal for Chicago. That is where we stand, 2-1 at the half. Now time for the Chicago Red Stars halftime show presented by CJ Wilson Mazda, where you can drive with the Red Stars drive. We'll recap the first half and preview the second a little bit later coming on. But first, we're going to enjoy a ceremony from the field where the Red Stars are going to honor retired Red Stars player Julianne Sitch. We'll return after with first half highlights. It's all part of the Red Stars CJ Wilson halftime show, which will continue after these messages.
Halftime of this Red Stars game is presented by CJ Wilson Mazda. CJ Wilson Mazda is offering Red Stars fans $500 on their next CJ Wilson Mazda. Bring your ticket stub with you on your CJ Wilson Mazda test drive for details. Drive with the Red Stars drive. Visit CJ Wilson Mazda online at ZoomZoomNation.com. Visit them in Orland Park on 159th Street, in Countryside on LaGrange Road, and in Lake Villa on Grand Avenue.
Wouldn't it be great to feel this good every day? Doing the things you love with the people you love. At Illinois Bone and Joint Institute, we help people of all ages move better so they can live better. If an orthopedic injury or illness slows you down, we're here with everything you need. Enjoy the life you deserve. See what we can do for you at IBJI.com. IBJI, move better, live better.
Ladies and gentlemen, today we honor longtime Chicago Red Stars defender and midfielder Julianne Sitch, who announced her retirement from 13 years of professional soccer at the end of the 2014 season. Please help us in welcoming to the field now, Julianne Sitch. She is joined on the field today by her players from the University of Chicago women's soccer team. And now we ask that you please turn your attention to the video board for a special message to Sitch.
My name is Julianne Sitch. I play midfielder defense for the Chicago Red Stars.
And that play started with Julianne Sitch. It started with her single-handedly winning a tackle, going forward.
I started playing soccer when I was about 5 years old. Started on an all-boys team because there weren't too many girls' teams. And then went on to play club and collegiate soccer and now professional. I think for me, soccer just helped build the confidence level, build kind of who I was. Soccer just became that establishment of a place that I could go, express myself, be confident, be crazy, not be judged by anyone.
Julianne Sitch, and we are level at 3.
Be able to go back home and play in front of my family and friends and people that have supported me my whole life is just, you know, a dream come true. It's pretty unreal sometimes that I get to play professionally in my hometown.
No, stop it. This is for you. All right, I'm just going to give you some.
Thank you, Arno.
Awesome. Thank you. So, talk slowly and it might echo. Okay. So just, and if there's no.
Hello, Chicago. This is incredible. I'd like to thank Elise and Arnum and the whole staff of the Chicago Red Stars, including Rory, for the that I've had since I've been a little kid.
Here, back up a little bit.
As I said, I would like to thank Arnum and Elise and the whole staff of the Chicago Red Stars, including Rory, for giving me the opportunity to fulfill one of my dreams that I've had since a little kid, and that is to play professional soccer, but not only play professional soccer, but to play in my hometown, Chicago. Given the opportunity to play in front of all of my family and friends has been a dream come true. Unfortunately, my dad couldn't be here tonight, but I know he's watching on the webcast, so I'd like to give a special shout out to my dad for someone who has supported me my whole entire career, went out into the streets and painted marks for me to do all my fitness and sat there with the time watch, making sure that I made all of my times to go into college and to go into the pros. Without my dad and my mom, who unfortunately cannot be here tonight, as she passed away, but without the support of my family and my friends, I wouldn't be able to stand here tonight in front of all of you guys. And I'd also like to give a special shout out to the lovely ladies behind me. As I've been very blessed to work with the University of Chicago as one of my first jobs out of being a professional athlete, and these girls have inspired me more than they can even think of that they do, and an amazing boss that I have, Amy Reifert, that have just given me the tools to be myself and do what I love every single day and be passionate. So I'd like to give them a special thank you for everything, and thank you, the Chicago fans, for all the support that you guys have me throughout my career, because without you guys out there every single day in the rain, in the cold, you know, we thank you guys very much, and a special shout out to the super fans over there in the corner. But thank you again, Chicago, for giving me the opportunity to play here in Chicago. I can't be more honored than I am tonight. Thank you.
Oh,
Thank you, Julianne, for everything you have done for the Chicago Red Stars. We are beyond proud of your accomplishments off the field as well, as you continue to help youth and young women in the Chicagoland area through your coaching and training. We will be fans of yours for life and know that you'll always have another family here with the Chicago Red Stars. Fans, another round of applause for Julianne Sitch.
Halftime of this Red Stars game is presented by CJ Wilson Mazda. CJ Wilson Mazda is offering Red Stars fans $500 on their next CJ Wilson Mazda. Bring your ticket stub with you on your CJ Wilson Mazda test drive for details. Drive what the Red Stars drive. Visit CJ Wilson Mazda online at zoomzoomnation.com. Visit them in Orland Park on 159th Street, in Countryside on LaGrange Road, and in Lake Villa on Grand Avenue.
Wouldn't it be great to feel this good every day? Doing the things you love with the people you love. At Illinois Bone and Joint Institute, we help people of all ages move better so they can live better. If an orthopedic injury or illness slows you down, we're here with everything you need. Enjoy the life you deserve. See what we can do for you at IBJI.com. IBJI, move better, live better.
Back here at Toyota Park, Bridgeview, Illinois, we have got a good one between Chicago and Seattle. Jackie Manny and Lisa Byington with you. It is a 2-1 halftime score. Seattle got the first two on the board. Mellis in the 5th minute, Barnes in the 9th minute. DiBernardo actually has the assist, not the goal, for Chicago in the 27th minute. Sofia Huerta is the one with the goal. DiBernardo got the assist. Again, that happened in the 27th minute. So that's where we stand here, 2-1 at halftime. Let's take a look at the first half highlights. There was plenty to choose from between these two teams. We had some defensive stops. We have obviously three goals here in the first 45, and both of these coaches thought that there might be a little bit of scoring, and we got it right out of the gates.
You see a diagonal ball by Yanez right into Melis's run, and she scores again, right foot, just right past Nair early in the game.
Yana's third assist of 2016, and Mellis, her third goal in a couple of games, and nicely played. So Mellis now with 6 goals on the year, and half of those goals have come in the last 2 games. This was an absolutely perfectly placed ball on the free kick from Lauren Barnes in the 9th minute, just 4 minutes later.
You see her lineup. She takes it with the inside of her left, bends it up and around the Chicago wall, and just slips one right into the near post past Nair.
First goal of 2016 for Lauren Barnes. And then on the beautiful cross and the beautiful finish, it was DiBernardo to Sofia Huerta.
Similar to last week, a corner kick by Vanessa DiBernardo. Huerta on the back post, she gets up and over her defender and just knocks it right into the upper corner.
And so Sofia Huerta now with 5 goals on the year. One more look at it. Beautifully placed ball from DiBernardo. And the finish from Huerta, and that is where we stand. It is a 2-1 score between Seattle and Chicago. Again, it is a tight race to make top 4 of the NWSL. The top 4 go to the playoffs at the end of the year. And counting tonight, both of these clubs have 4 matches left. Chicago coming into tonight in this match with 28 points, just sitting 5 ahead of the Seattle Reign, who's on the outside right now, coming into tonight, looking in terms of trying to be one of those top 4.
They're just starting to find their stride in this season. They've struggled so far on the year, which is not typical for Seattle team, who usually does so well in the season. But I think they'll find their stride, and they will be dangerous come the playoff hunt.
Both of these teams have a tough road ahead in their final 4 games, a matchup here tonight between 2 really hungry teams trying to position themselves. And Chicago has a couple of matches against FCKC. You could label them as maybe a hungry team and a dangerous team. And then they finish off the year against Washington, first place in the NWSL. As for Seattle's final leg of its schedule, as I mentioned, they have to play Washington, the first place Spirit team, twice, 2 out of the next 3 games.
Great ball by Vanessa DiBernardo. She gets that on her left foot, finds Gillen, which, again, we've said over and over, makes Chicago so good when they can get those outside backs forward into the attack.
I want to remind you, in every Red Stars home match, we have an online auction going on tonight. You can text the code word Red Stars to 52182. Some of the prizes is you can bid on a Karina LeBlanc signed jersey, an Aaron Gilliland warm-up top, and an on-field experience for 4 at a future Red Stars match. All you have to do, text the code word Red Stars to 52182. We will have that available up until the 70th minute of play here tonight. Casey Short to the hands of Haley Kottmeyer. Kottmeyer again getting the start for the Seattle Reign in the place of Hope Solo. She has done an excellent job, to the point that Hope Solo even mentioned her in her statement when she announced that she would take an indefinite leave from the Reign. Talked about how she watched how well that Haley Kottmeyer had played and felt like the team would be in good hands.
She did, and she just knows the expectations of the team. She knows how the team plays, and because of all of the World Cup Olympics the last 2 years, she's had tons of experience in Hope Solo's absence. So not to say it's an easy role to fill, but it is a pretty comfortable change just in terms of how much she's played with this team.
It's been about a month since Chicago has played here at home. As we mentioned in the first half, they're awfully good here at Toyota Park. Unbeaten, the last unbeaten team here in the NWSL, playing in their home stadium. 4-0-3 record here at Toyota Park. But it's been a month since they have played on this grass. Huerta working that right sideline. Up against Lauren Barnes.
Chicago coming out of the gate so much stronger than they did in the first half. Just have their outside backs wrapped. Their midfield's getting up a little bit higher, and they've already generated a couple scoring opportunities just by getting up that right flank.
Be interesting as we get to about the 60th minute of play, what both of these coaches, if this remains a tight match, what both of these coaches decide to do with some of the substitutions here in this second half. Of course, we have a Megan Rapinoe who is available once again for Seattle. If You missed it. She got a goal in her season debut in the last match against Portland. That was in stoppage time. And I mean, that was like seconds away from it being a final.
Right before that whistle blew, she got on the end of one and just buried a shot home with her left foot. And when you're coming back from an injury like that, it is so good to start off on the right foot, get a goal under your belt. It just makes things so much easier. It makes you more comfortable, so much faster.
Beautifully placed, as you mentioned, with her left foot in the side netting. And then the reaction of the bench, the Seattle bench, just showed you what that kind of goal meant to them emotionally as a team to see her back.
It did. And it wasn't just the players that got excited. Laura Harvey was jumping on the top of that huddle. Everyone was so excited and happy for Megan Rapinoe to be able to get into the lineup and just score and get that camel off of her back.
Pressure coming from Kristen Press, who's been a little bit of a non-factor here. Casey Short with the takeaway. And a foul coming up. Chicago's going to get a free kick in a really good spot.
You see Casey Short, she takes the ball into her right foot. Thinks she was looking for a shot on goal, but Mathias gets in. She clips her late and just kind of gets her right ankle.
Part of Merritt Mathias's game is her physicality. A whistle for the foul there on that play. It'll be Kristen Press, DiBernardo, Danny Colaprico. There's four of them all around the ball. And Colaprico moves off, and so Sofia Huerta and DiBernardo and Kristen Press are lining up. Kristen Press will take it. She's going right at that left side.
Very similar approach that you saw Lauren Barnes score on earlier in the game. Not a big run up. She just takes it with the inside of her foot and tries to bend it up and over into that near post.
Cecily Peacock turning 14.
Trying to play it up here to Kim Little.
Happy birthday, and thanks for enjoying it here with the Red Stars.
In that first half, it was a 7-4 shot differential, a Seattle advantage in the first 45 minutes. Both teams getting one corner chance. Seattle getting five of those seven shots on target.
Chicago's got a much higher line in terms of where they're pressuring Seattle, and it's giving Seattle a little bit harder time defensively trying to get it out of their back.
They didn't really have that high line in the first half.
They didn't, and that allows Seattle to get their outside backs going, kind of set play from the back and really build possession-wise into their attack. And having that higher pressing line just makes it a little bit harder for them to get their players going forward.
Direct ball, dribble right to the feet of Haley Kottmeyer. Red Star Soccer 2016, presented by the Illinois Bone and Joint Institute, proud presenting partner of the Chicago Red Stars, the Illinois Bone and Joint Institute. Move better, live better. Learn more at IBJI.com. Manon Mellis will take it and found the hand of Kim Little. Again, our online auction, text the code word Red Stars to 52182. You have up until the 70th minute of play for a Karina LeBlanc signed jersey, Aaron Gilliland warm-up top, and an on-field experience for four at a future Red Stars match. Text the code word Red Stars to 52182. Jackie Manny, Lisa Byington with you. This is a playoff positioning game between Seattle and Chicago. Flag is up. They got Kawasui. Naho Kawasumi whistled for the offside. That's the first for Seattle tonight. Rory Daines, what will he do here in the second half? He does have Taylor Como available. Be interesting to see if he chooses to use her. DiBernardo trying to find Gilliland, who had pushed up.
A typical situation for Red Stars is to get Kristen Press a little bit closer to goal and bump her into that front line just to find her around the goal more, get more scoring opportunities with her right in the box.
Rory Dames, a big weekend. His little daughter Olivia turning 2 years old. They had to celebrate that over the weekend. She could be a gymnast in the making. They got her a
trampoline. I know.
For a birthday party.
Big birthday party tomorrow, he said. So happy birthday to Olivia.
I hope she wasn't listening. I might have given away the gift. She probably couldn't understand that. Right?
She's only two.
Right. 54 minute of play between these two. Melis, you can just tell by the way she carries herself even when she's on the ball. Just a lot of confidence.
She does, and she is just so relentless in her attack.
Over to the left side, Usugi. Playing it in, oh, Nair with the reaction save. Alyssa Nair, after giving up two goals, has been absolutely lights out since.
She has. She is so good with her shot-stopping ability. Her reaction time is so good. You see Yanez have a diving header from maybe 3 or 4 yards out, and Nair is able to slide and just get her hands on it and then collect the ball easily.
That is the second time that she has robbed Bev Yanez tonight. She had a double save, you could call it, in the first half. One of the best ones that we've seen all year.
She has. She just makes such great saves from those point-blank ranges. She is so good.
Can you tie yourself for NWSL Save of the Week?
She had a great save to win it last week, so I don't know. We'll see.
Oh, look at the reaction from Laura Harvey. Thought her team would go up 3-1. Great stuff by our crew to capture that reaction. Keelan Winters staying with it.
It's really the first time in the half that Seattle's generated enough offense to get into their attacking half and keep the ball and find some sort of rhythm.
Red Stars broadcast brought to you in part by Blooming Color, the official printer of the Chicago Red Stars. They've made area businesses stand out for the past 25 years and are looking forward to serve you as well. For all your printing needs, whatever the size or scale, find them online at bloomingcolor.com. 2-1 score, Seattle, Chicago. Chicago's sitting in a tie for fourth. Really a tie for third, but tied for with Western New York with 28 points, followed by Portland in second with 29 and the Washington Spirit with 36. And right behind them on the outside looking in is Seattle with 23 points. Here's Casey Short. She's got some space. Takes a try.
Casey Short's finding herself so high into that attack, and she's been successful when they find her on that left flank.
DiBernardo nearly had a takeaway. Fishlock went down, and we have a foul against Chicago. You can see how important Jessica Fishlock is in the middle of the field for the Seattle team.
She is. She covers so much ground offensively and defensively, and she just sees the game so well. She's such a fierce competitor, such high energy. She's a hard player to manage in the midfield for 90 minutes.
There's another player hard to manage, Vanessa DiBernardo in the middle of the field, number 10 for Chicago, one of the players on this team, one of the five who have played over 1,400 minutes right now for the Red Stars. Coming into tonight, DiBernardo is 14-28.
She's so consistent in her play. She really doesn't have a ton of ups and downs.
First substitution. Cara Walls is out.
Replaced by number 13, Amanda DaCosta.
And Amanda DaCosta is now in for Chicago.
And that little change allows Kristen Press to go up top, and then you see Vanessa DiBernardo go into that number 10 space, that attacking mid spot for Chicago, and they'll just be able to get a couple more scoring threats closer to the goal, which when you're down 2-1, it's a big advantage.
Pushes McCaffrey and Press now at the top spots, the top forward spots here for Chicago, and I think Rory Dames likes to see what McCaffrey and Press can do together up there.
They'll be a good little duo. They'll play well off of each other. I think they complement each other well in terms of their style of play. And this is really one of the first games that they'll be able to see really what they're going to be capable of up top together.
Again, we may or may not see Taylor Como in the midfield for Chicago. She's dealing with a right hamstring. She is available, listed as a sub tonight, but she is not completely 100%.
You see Seattle just kind of compacting that back line, making it hard for Chicago to get anything in and out of that midfield.
You may not realize it, but again, the Chicago Red Stars Academy offers girls ages 8 through 17 elite training through residential day camps and personal training. You can find it through Chicagoland and Indiana and Wisconsin. If you are interested, you can head to redstarsacademy.com for more information. Kawasumi on the right side. Back to Kawasumi. She found the feet of Melis. So Kawasumi and Melis working together. A nice turn from Little. I don't know how she was able to keep control of that. She did a complete 360 to get that shot off. Kim Little got her start in the Scottish Women's Premier League. Stands a big 5'3" on this field.
Just a tiny little quick crafty thing, but she's so effective.
Kristen Press running on one-on-one against Kuttmeyer and can't put it away. That's the kind of opportunity Chicago wants to have.
See Kristen Press, she takes a great touch, gets past the defender, tries to cut it to her left and just cuts her angle a little bit too short to be able to slip that ball in through the near post. You see here again, she finds the ball at her feet, cuts it to her left, and then just misses it by just a foot to the left of the post.
Do you think she had the angle to go far post instead of near post?
Kottmeyer did a good job at coming in from the get-go. I think she was trying to get it off of that first touch. Kottmeyer does a good job of cutting that angle, making herself big in front of the goal. So I think Kristen Press thought she had to take another touch to try and get around her and just cut her angle a little bit too small.
Fishlock will keep it. You can see the speed. Fishlock playing it through to Melis.
A huge defensive stop by Julie Johnson. She makes that look so easy. She looks so cool on the ball. That's a great job by Julie to keep it at 2-1.
McCaffrey to Press, trying to go right back at McCaffrey.
You'll see here again, Julie Johnson, she makes a sliding save, is able to keep possession, get up, and then she starts that attack on that counterattack. As soon as she finds the ball at her feet, she gets up, she goes, and she sets play again.
How many center backs can do that? Johnston playing to the feet of press. And a nice defensive stance from Mathias. Press will get another chance, and it's Kottmeyer with the one-handed save.
What a save by Kottmeyer. That is huge by Haley Kottmeyer.
We have seen some impressive performances by both keepers tonight.
Kristen Press shoots it with her left. Kottmeyer totally lays out, get herself parallel to the floor, and just knocks it out for a corner with her left hand.
Here's DiBernardo. And Kottmeyer has it.
Two huge saves by each team's goalkeeper. This is really the first time in the game that we're seeing some back and forth action. It's been a pretty possession-oriented game so far, where you're seeing the attacks build a little bit more instead of those longer, diagonal, direct-type style plays.
Haley Kottmeyer is right at her average. She only gives up one goal a game. It is a 2-1 Seattle lead in the second half. Kawasumi. IYSA, a proud sponsor of the Chicago Red Stars. One of the final few home matches that we have here at Toyota Park. This is three games in about 8 days for Chicago. This is a tough stretch for the Red Stars. Another match coming up on Wednesday. Again, that's a 7 p.m. kick, a nationally televised match on Fox Sports 1. For all details, and even if you're interested in attending that match, you can go to chicagoredstars.com.
Chicago's defense is doing a much better job at staying a little bit more compact, not letting those diagonal runs come through. In the first half, you saw them get stuck a little bit in their play. They kind of lost players in between the lines. They're doing a much better job communicating, keeping track of all those players, such as Mellis and Kawasumi up top.
Here's Winters. We'll get it out to Fishlock. Trying to play it directly to Kim Little up top.
Fans, last chance to bid on tonight's silent auction prizes. The auction will end in approximately the 70th minute of the match. Bid now to take home great prizes and support the Red Stars charitable tickets initiative.
I think we might have a Megan Rapinoe sighting. Looks like Rapinoe's getting set to check in. So she'll get a few more minutes than what she got in her season debut against Portland.
And regardless of where she's at, fitness-wise or play-wise, even if she's not 100% yet, she's a spark for Seattle. She brings that experience, that personality when she plays. She has so much confidence when she plays as well. I think it's just an overall spark for this whole Seattle team whenever you see her enter the game.
She's torn her ACL three times, most recently on the right knee. She tore her ACL twice on her left knee in college. She played for Portland. Battling back from the most recent ACL. It's kind of on spot duty for the U.S. national team. And here we have Megan Rapinoe. making her entrance. You can hear the home crowd appreciating that. And she might be coming in for Manon Mellis. And she is. Does that surprise you?
It does a little bit. Mellis is just a huge threat for them up top. We'll see what the changes are formation-wise as Megan Rapinoe enters the game.
It'll be interesting to see Rapinoe and Mellis kind of work together in this game, but we won't see that happening. So Rapinoe's in for Mellis.
And you'll see Megan Rapinoe come out to that left side and Yanez come inside. And then Kim Little get bumped up in replacement for Mellis up top.
Mellis again with one of the two goals here for Seattle. She's got 6 on the year and her day is now done. Into the 70th minute we go. Little making a run up the right flank, keeping it in play up against Casey Short. And a goal kick coming up. Red Stars broadcast brought to you in part by Shaw Media, an official news partner of the Chicago Red Stars in 2015. For all the news happening in the suburbs of Chicago, you can head to mysuburbanlife.com. Beautiful night. Almost perfect weather here for a soccer match between Seattle and Chicago. We're at Bridgeview, Illinois at Toyota Park. Up top to Kristen Press once again. Tell you what, Chicago has gotten some looks that it's wanted to get here after that substitution was made with DaCosta pushing Press up top to work with Steph McCaffrey in this second half.
They definitely have, but with that change, they've kind of found a more direct style of play. They still need to get their outside backs up and find the width before they find their top runners. So it's kind of been straight into the front runners' feet. Not a ton of width to the game so far since that change.
Visit 120 IDJI locations, and you'll find everything you need all in one place, from MRI and pain management to rehab therapy and specialized care. Visit IDJI.com to learn.
Playing it up to Kawasumi. Kawasumi has Rapinoe making a run into the box. Keeps it herself. Here's Little trying to turn. Back to Kawasumi. A diagonal pass. Utsugi couldn't finish.
Some tough movement by Seattle to defend. You saw Rapinoe make that diagonal run into the box, and then Utsugi just gets all the way up into the attack.
All the scoring happening tonight in the first half between these two teams, and really in the first 30 minutes of play. In the 5th and the 9th minute for Seattle, and in the 27th minute for Chicago. Fishlock will keep it on the right side. Rapinoe wanted it. Kawasumi finds her. Rapinoe with the half chance. So good with that left foot.
Such good footwork just to be able to halt her body movement, get her left foot on the ball, and be able to keep that ball in play just off of one touch.
Handball. And a free kick for Chicago. A quick restart back to Julie Johnston. Huerta battling on the end line. Sam Johnson to the head of Huerta. Kristen Press doesn't need that much time or space to launch it.
She has the ability to just take her shot with so little space and so quickly on the ball.
And the quick turn and the velocity of that shot. So impressive.
She scored so many goals for Chicago just by off of those quick little turns. You think you have her covered, you think you don't have enough space on her, and then all of a sudden she's able to fire a shot and in the goal.
That's almost her money spot right at the top of the 18 there.
Top of the 18 on almost those half chance opportunities often.
#CRS07 50-50 ball, Fishlock wins it. Fishlock wanted a call. She didn't get it. Thought there was a little bit more extracurricular body contact made. Here comes the pressure by Little. And McCaffrey charging in on Kottmeyer. Between Little and Johnston. Paired number eight's going at it. Paired number eight still going at it.
And similar in terms of their strength. They're strong, they're a little bit shorter, they're so hard to get off the ball. And we'll start to see Julie Johnston get up a little bit higher as this game closes out.
Get if you want to wear what the Red Stars are wearing here on this field, go to redstarsgear.com. You can find all kinds of gear, sweatshirts, jerseys. Pick your favorite. Here's Press. And Casey Short running out wide. Back to the middle. It was about all that McCaffrey could do with it. You wanted them to go out wide. Casey Short was kind of pulling out wide, but instead they went again with a direct style up top.
And Seattle, kudos to them. They're so good at plugging up the midfield. But they're finding something in Chicago in terms of wanting to find straight up into their forwards. And they're just not getting a ton out of it. They lost Carol Walls, who did a great job for them in the first half at holding that ball up. And they just don't have that type of forward right now.
Here's Amanda DaCosta, number 13. And the subs that were made here in the second half for Chicago. Katie Naughton, Alyssa Motz, Taylor Como, Sarah Gordon, Courtney Reitzman, all available as field players and reserves here tonight for Chicago. Casey Short. Back to Short on this left side. Cut back, falls down, in, we're gonna have a penalty kick coming up. Short went down in the box, and Chicago now with a chance here to tie it, and a yellow card handed out.
You see Casey Short here on the left. She takes her touch to her right, gets clipped by Matthias.
And so it'll be Kristen Press against Haley Kottmeyer to tie this matchup. Press gets it. Right corner. We're tied at two.
Confidence from the Red Stars getting her into this position and letting her step up and bury the ball into the right side of the goal.
Last time Kristen Press took a PK was in the Olympics and she missed. She wasn't going to miss tonight.
What a great opportunity for her to get that boost of confidence and put Chicago at a tie game with just 11 minutes left.
In the 79th minute, Kristen Press gets her sixth goal of the year, and we're tied at two.
This game is finally starting to come alive a little bit. You hear the stands getting into it. You hear Coach Rory Dames on the sideline getting into it, and the energy is picked up by both sides.
We knew there would be some scoring, we knew there would be some action, and we knew there would be some intensity between these two clubs, both battling to make one of the top four spots in the NWSL and make the playoffs.
It's a huge night for both teams.
Press called for the offside.
When you're at this time in the season, it's playoff time. When you're close on that bubble, which both these teams are, it just makes the end of the season such a grind. Like we talked about, both these teams kind of love that feeling, love having their backs against the walls.
Here's Rapino to Kawisuma. Back to Kawisuma. She gets an outside run from Mathias if she wants to use it. Plays it out to Merritt Mathias, who plays it into the box, and Nara was reading that one.
It's a great ball in by Mathias. Not a ton of options coming into the box for it, though. And then Nair's able to quickly release Press down the sideline, and Chicago's already in there attacking half.
Under 10 minutes to play now, and this one locked at two between Seattle and Chicago. A draw would not do Seattle very well.
Especially coming into those last two games against Washington.
As I mentioned, Seattle with a chance to move up the standings. Three of their last four games against teams who are sitting above them. Two with Washington and tonight against Chicago. And the Red Stars really trying to hold serve here to make the top four. Third minute of play. Kawisuma to a Kendall Fletcher who has pushed up. We have a little talking to Kim Little. And Vanessa DiBernardo is slow to get up.
Seattle Rain substitution in the 83rd minute, leading the match number 17, Beverly Yannick.
The substitution, Carson Pickett. is in for Bev Yanez for Seattle. So Laura Harvey taking out Mellis and Yanez here in the second half. Both have, especially in that first half, generated a lot of great offensive looks here for the Rain. Casey Short, who generated that penalty kick, has it here on the left side and finds Kristen Press.
She's been so good in the second half at joining the attack. Seattle's had a hard time dealing with her on this left flank.
Now into the 85th minute. Jackie Manning, Lisa Byington with you. Been a lot to talk about here tonight between Chicago and Seattle. Two very hungry clubs. Playoff positioning on the line. Here's Kim Little going right at Julie Johnston. Little. And Johnston somehow read that.
Kim Little is so hard to play against 1v1 defensively. And Julie Johnston does such a good job at moving her feet and just finding that little tap to get the ball wide and clear.
Well, she made it look easy. Here's Kawesuma trying to turn. Trying to go at DaCosta. Final few minutes of play here between these two clubs. Will we see the intensity even pick up from what we've seen in the first 85 minutes of play?
It's been a fairly even game so far, as the score reflects lots of back and forth action.
It's what you would expect when Chicago and Seattle tangle. Fairly even overall series between these two clubs. Who's going to go for it here in the final few minutes? Here's Kawesuma. Again, a run from Mathias. The push up, here's Merritt Mathias. On the right side, Mathias will place it in. Misplayed ball, nearly an own goal from Sam Johnson. Rapino will take a shot, and man, the Chicago Red Stars, Alyssa Nair, are happy that that post was there. Sam Johnson nearly had an own goal.
A hard ball to deal with as a center back, and she did a good job at getting it up and out, but just nicks that crossbar. So lucky by Sam Johnson, gets on her left foot and hits that crossbar. Rapido gets on the end of it. She's hoping for a handball.
Pressure coming from McCaffrey. Pressure coming from Press. Pressure now coming from DiBernardo. The intensity has picked up for both of these teams.
Any teams that are part of the Illinois Women's Soccer League can earn 10 free tickets to the match.
Game is starting to open up a little bit more. It's the last 4 minutes or so that teams can go after it.
Intensity picking up for the head coaches. You see Laura Harvey trying to get the most out of her club in the final few minutes of play.
Both Laura Harvey and Rory Dames just driving their teams from the sidelines, trying to add in any energy that they can.
Rapino getting sandwiched, somehow spun out of that. Here's Mathias. Merritt Mathias going 1v1 against Casey Short. Mathias, physical player. Short trying to match it. Corner coming up for Seattle.
It's been a great matchup between Casey Short and Merritt Mathias on this right and left flank of them going forward. Similar players that both like to drive into the attack. And they've been a good battle against each other this whole game.
It will be the lefty, Lauren Barnes, taking it. Kawesumi is over there for the short corner possibility. Barnes drives one, top of the six. It's open. There's a chance for Seattle, and Chicago looking to clear.
It's another great stop by Alyssa Nair.
Utsugi trying to play it off the Red Stars and won't get it. One more look at it. This corner.
See this in-swinger corner. Keelan Winters gets her head on it, and Alyssa Nair just pounces on the ball, tries to get something, but bats it clear of the six.
Alyssa Nair has been fantastic tonight. Could have been a handball, no call. Playing it up to Fishlock, who's battling again with Casey Short. Seattle really challenging Short here down the stretch. We didn't have any stoppage time in the first half. We are now in the final minute of our 90 minutes. Will we have stoppage time here in this second half?
There should be some, but there won't be much added on to the second half either.
Few substitutions made between these two teams. No real stoppage and injuries in this game. It's been fairly quick, fairly clean game between these two. Kawasumi playing it up to the top of the 18.
You'll see two more substitutions from Chicago to close out the game tonight.
And we have 2 minutes of stoppage time as well. Tie match here between Seattle and Chicago. Sofia Huerta will come off. We have Katie Naughton and Alyssa Motz coming on for Chicago.
Chicago Red Stars substitutions in stoppage time in match number 9.
Naughton normally playing on the back line for the Red Stars. Looks like she's lining up in the midfield.
Yeah, she'll find that holding mid spot alongside Danny Colaprico just to plug up the midfield a little bit more defensively for Chicago.
Well, Motz will play on the left side in the midfield position. And Press will remain on top, playing it out to Motz. Motz into the game. We'll play it back to Casey Short. And now stretching into that 2 minutes of stoppage time. Meyer pushing all the way up. Maybe one last chance for Seattle.
Good clearance by Casey Short.
Yeah, both these teams desperate for the 3 points. That's going to do it. A draw between Chicago and Seattle. The 1 point does Chicago better than it does Seattle in this kind of situation.
It does. Seattle, just like we've talked about all game, backs against the wall right now. Wanted that win. They started the game off huge with those two early goals and just weren't able to hold Chicago off the board.
Again, Mellis got things started real early in the 5th minute, followed by Barnes with the free kick in the 9th minute. Again, Vanessa DiBernardo got the assist, not the goal, in the 27th minute. It was Sofia Huerta who got the goal. And Kristen Press tied things up with a penalty kick in the 79th minute. We saw some scoring. And we saw some incredible goalkeeping here tonight from both keepers.
We did. Both keepers came up so huge in different spaces tonight in the game.
Jackie Manny, Lisa Byington with you. We are sure happy that you tuned in to watch this one. A 2-2 draw between Chicago and Seattle. Both clubs will pick up a point as we head down the finish of the NWSL regular season. And it is a sprint to get to the top four spots. Thanks for joining us as we sign off here from Toyota Park.